All right, what's going on, everybody? It's Friday, so it's time for yet another Zombies Top 5. Today, we're doing the top 5 worst Call of Duty Zombies maps in history. I'm just ranking these on the maps that I really just don't enjoy playing. I don't have a fun experience really playing them, and I just kind of find them boring, to be honest. But anyways, yeah, for this list, I'm going to be excluding Black Ops 4 maps. I'm not even going to put any Black Ops 4 maps in here, just because I haven't played enough Black Ops 4 Zombies to even, like, have an opinion on those maps. So, I mean, one of them would probably make this list, maybe in the future, once I eventually play Black Ops 4 Zombies. I know it's, like, 2 years old, but we'll get on that someday. And just a quick shout-out to the Matster. He does make a few of my thumbnails if you guys are enjoying them. If you think they look sweet, go check him out. Link down in the description to his channel. Thank you so much, dude. I appreciate it. But anyways, let's get into this top 5. Alright, so coming into the number 5 spot, we've got Shinonuma Zombies. Now, I think Shinonuma did a few things right. You know, you've got the Wunderwaff, you've got the dogs, you've got the Flogger, which is one of the most iconic traps ever in the history of Call of Duty Zombies. But my main problem with this map is, like, all you can do is get to high rounds. And I know that might not sound fair. Like, what do you want, a full-fledged Easter egg out in a World at War map? And I mean, obviously that's not going to happen. But when I'm ranking this against every other map that's ever been made, it really just deserves this spot. Because even getting to the high rounds, I mean, on solo can be a lot of fun because there's only like 24 zombies per wave, so you can get to like around 1,000 in like a day. But the problem is when it comes to co-op with this map, because the thing I think about this map is everybody's just doing their own thing, they're off doing their own thing, there's no set place for you guys to camp. So when I'm playing with friends, I really just don't enjoy this map all that much because we're each doing our own thing. It's okay. I mean, I like the random perk system, that's fun, but nevertheless, when ranked against every other zombies map ever made, I think Shinonuma takes the 5th spot as the worst, the 5th worst. Coming in at the number 4 spot, we've got Ascension Zombies. Now, my main problem with Ascension is pretty much the same thing as Shinonuma. All you do on this map is get to high rounds. I mean, there is a small Easter egg quest, but I don't really enjoy it. I'm kind of more of a complex person. I like when there's a lot to do on the map, and this is just way too easy in an experience. I mean, you got the Thunder Gun, you've got so many training spots. Literally every single place is open. You've got PhD and Mustang and Sally, which is like the greatest combo ever. It makes such an easy experience. And overall, it really gets boring, because really the truth is you can get to whatever round you want. However much time you have is how long you're going to grind it out. So yeah, I put this map below Shinonuma because, like, I think getting the high rounds on Shinonuma can actually be a little bit more fun than on this map, just because they go by quicker and it feels a lot more rewarding. But nevertheless, Ascension, not a very good map, takes the number 4 spot, 4th worst zombies map ever. So coming in at the number 3 spot, we have got Black Ops 1 Moon. Now, I really don't like this map, from like the colors, the way it looks. It's just, it's gray, it's not that interesting. I mean, this was the big end of Black Ops 1 Zombies, and they gave us a, like, the Easter egg has an amazing ending. But the process to getting there is just so boring because it's so RNG-based. There's not a whole lot of killing. I find that to be very boring, a little underwhelming, honestly. The ending was great, though, but the process to getting there was boring. And I mean, maybe I'll have a fun time playing this map, but between, like, the teleporting crawlers, which, like, nobody likes those, and just the muffled sound effects through your helmet, I mean, I really just don't like this map. I mean, in Black Ops 3 when it was remastered, I really enjoyed it, but the Black Ops 1 version, the OG version, I really have just no fun playing this map. Moon from Black Ops 1 is the 3rd worst zombies map ever. So coming in at the number 2 spot, we've got Transit. Now, Transit did not take the number 1 spot. I mean, it's just so popular to hate on Transit, put it the number 1 worst zombies map of all time. But honestly, Transit can be a fun experience every now and then. I mean, yes, the pack punch sequence is terrible. Yes, the lava everywhere. Yes, the denizens. Everything sucks. The jet gun is, like, everything's terrible on this map. But honestly, like, just camping on the bus with your friends, that could be a fun experience. I mean, there's a few ways to make this map fun, but nevertheless, it's still a terrible map. There's so many things wrong with it. It was such a good concept. Terrible execution, though, and we need this remastered Treyarch, please. But nevertheless, this map is just, it's so, look at these colors. It's just so bad. It's going to take the number 2 spot. Transit, not a good map. And just like everybody else, Transit is on a top 5 worst zombies list. Verrucht. Verrucht is my least favorite Call of Duty Zombies map ever. And it's just like, it's just so boring, it's so bare bones. You'll be like, bro, it's a Call of Duty World at War Zombies map. You can't hate on it, but when I'm ranking up against every single map ever made, I just look at it and I'm like, ew. Like, there's so many better experiences than this. Like, yes, you can go camp in that little room with the bar. You can also camp on the catwalk on Duri, so you can camp upstairs and knock. There's just such better maps than this map. It's so boring. But what about the cool features where, like, you spawn on 2 different spawn rooms, the power will reunite you. Yeah, except power's, like, not even that far away. You can get there by, like, round 4 and get reunited, so it's really not that big of a deal anyway. I mean, the map did introduce perks, which is huge. That's awesome. But nevertheless, that doesn't make up for, like, the just boring gameplay. Like, there's just nothing. It's so boring. Like, I mean, the setting's kind of cool, but the colors are just, like, brown and orange. It's just, I really don't like Verrucht. It's my least favorite Call of Duty Zombies map of all time, just because every single time I play it, I just get so bored. But anyways, yeah, that was my top 5 least favorite Call of Duty Zombies ever made. If you disagree, leave it in the comments down below. If you made it to the end, I seriously appreciate it. Again, every single map is Zombies content, so it's good, but these maps just disappointed me. Anyways, yeah, hope you all enjoyed. I'll see you next week for another top 5 Call of Duty Zombies list. It's been Smitty. Peace out, everybody. Have a great rest of your day.